So I'm a scientist at the National Centre for Atmospheric Research, that's NCAR. As a scientist, I try to improve the methods that we're using for applied problems. A lot of like the planning assessments are now beginning to take into account climate change. And a lot of water managers now are interested in what's going to be the impact of climate change on their water resources. Okay. It's becoming increasingly clear that our climate is non-stationary. The variability in the past is not perhaps a good proxy for the future, that things might be changing. We don't know, you know, what those changes will be, but you know, we can estimate those changes using time-stepping simulation models. What we're doing is we're looking at some applied science questions that can support water management. Okay? So that really falls into two categories. One is to support the short-term operations. Okay, so this is like the short-term dam operations. The main information source that we can help provide and improve is hydroclimatic monitoring and prediction products. How much snow do we have in the basins? How wet are the basins? Right. What is the stream flow likely to be in the basins in the next day, in the next week, in the next month, over the next season? So we've got a lot of research going on in that area that's trying to characterise the uncertainties that we have in getting snapshots of current conditions as well as forecasts of future conditions, and ways that we can reduce those uncertainties by using advanced forecasting technologies that we can get from numerical weather prediction models, advanced information sources that we can get from satellites. For the long term, it's more related to water resources planning. So understanding like how our availability of water and how the variability of water will change in the future under climate change. So there we're looking at the methods that we're using to downscale, like to get information from the global scale atmospheric models at really fine spatial scales that we need for the local scale water resources assessments. That's the processes of downscaling. Also the methods that we use to configure, calibrate and select the hydrological models that we use to translate the precipitation, temperature, radiation inputs, etc., that we get from the downscaled information from the climate models to provide information on the amount of stream flow in the rivers. It is a lot of process, and there's different levels of uncertainty that we have in each element of that modelling chain. We're trying to estimate the error in our simulations and communicate that error to the people who would use that information, so that they can understand where it's reliable, where it's not reliable, and the amount of weight that they can put on that information to support their planning needs.